Thank you for tuning in to Terry Swoop Videos. On today's video, I'm going to talk about the sad and tragic ending of Big Mama Thornton. Big Mama Thornton is one of the greatest blues singers of all time. She's known as the Queen of Blues, the Queen of Rock and Roll, because rock and roll was started from the blues. And the first hit rock and roll song was Hound Dog. And Big Mama Thornton was the first person to record this song in 1953. Now, her version of Hound Dog went to number one in the charts in 1953. It sold 2 million copies. It was an international hit. And in 1955, Elvis copied the song and did a cover of it. And his version sold 10 million copies. So today, most people remember Hound Dog as an Elvis song, but a lot of younger people don't realize that Big Mama Thornton was the first person to record this song. And she had a lot of success during the 1950s. But in the 1950s, most black music artists weren't allowed to collect royalties from their own music. She sold all these millions of records, but she wasn't allowed to collect royalties from her own music. And this is the reason why a lot of black music artists from the 1940s and 50s died broke. They sold all these millions of records, but most of these singers died broke. And that was the type of racist society that the country was in the 1950s. That was Jim Crow America. Ray Charles was the first singer to collect his own royalties. Ray Charles owned his own masters. And he paved the way for a lot of black singers to start collecting their own royalties and collecting their own from their own work. Big Mama Thornton could play every instrument. She could play the harmonica, she could play the drums, she could play the guitar, and she could sing any type of music. She could sing jazz, she could sing the blues, she could sing rock and roll. There's nothing that she couldn't do. She was a musical genius. Her only problem was is that she was an alcoholic. Similar to Billie Holiday, Billie Holiday was also a great blues singer who had problems with drugs and alcohol. And she died at a young age in 1959. But Big Mama Thornton, her main thing was alcohol. She never did any drugs. Her thing was just alcohol. And this is what caused her liver cirrhosis to get worse and worse as she got older. And she went from 400 pounds to 90 pounds. Now, my father died of liver cirrhosis. And liver cirrhosis causes you to lose a lot of weight. And that's exactly why she lost so much weight as she got older. Now, she ended up passing away in 1984. What's sad is she died broke and alone at 57 years old. Similar to Robert Johnson and Betsy Smith, the media honored her music more after she died than when she was alive. When she was alive, she was mostly looked at as an underrated singer who never really got the accolades that she deserved. But after she died, she got inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. She was inducted into the Blues Hall of Fame. So it blows me away how a lot of these singers are not appreciated until they're gone, but we didn't appreciate them when they were alive. And I just think that needs to change. I think this woman was a legend. She's one of the greatest blues singers of all time. A lot of people have different opinions about this topic. Leave a comment, rate, and subscribe.